start with kinematics of the rigid body. Fine? Please write down. Do you know what is a rigid body? You can't change its volume. Is water a rigid body? You can't deform it, basically. Okay? A rigid body is a hypothetical object. Right? Such objects do not exist. But approximately, we can say that any solid behaves like a rigid body. Right? Please write down, in a rigid body, a rigid body is an object which do not get deformed. Okay? Which do not get deformed. Now, in reality, every solid, if you apply some force, will have a stress, because of that strain will be produced and there is a deformation. Alright? But we'll assume that the forces are so less, so little, that the deformation is negligible. Okay? For example, if I stretch this television from left hand side, there is slight deformation, but that is negligible. We say that the amount of force that we are applying is so less that we can ignore it. Alright? Now, this is what the rigid body is, whatever you have written. Okay? But mathematically, how can you talk about it? A rigid body is something which do not get deformed. Alright? But can I say this in a mathematical way? Suppose, I'll help you, okay? Suppose I take 2 points on a rigid body. Yeah, tension infinity, but again, I'm telling you the way you should tell me. Okay? Tell me with respect to the 2 points on the rigid body. What should happen between the 2 points on the rigid body for it to be a rigid body? What? The distance between any 2 points on the rigid body is fixed. Please write down. Distance between any 2 points on a rigid body is fixed. Okay? Distance between them neither increase nor decrease. Alright? So suppose you have point A and this is point B. Distance between them is suppose 20 cm. It will remain 20 cm no matter what the rigid body does. If it changes, then essentially rigid body is getting deformed. And then you can't call it a rigid body. Fine? Is this a rigid body, this pen? Is it? This is not a rigid body. When I rotate the cap, the distance between the points are changing. Take a point over here on the cap and take a point over here. These 2 points. When I rotate, that point goes backwards. So distance is changing. So as a whole, this doesn't behave like a rigid body. Are you getting it? Now, if distance between the 2 points is fixed, can one point move relative to the other point? Is it possible? Can they move? Yes. How many said no? How many say yes? Others, what are you doing here? I am saying that if distance between the 2 points is fixed, like the case in the rigid body, can they move relative to each other? They can't move relative to each other? Yes or no? How many say they can't move relative to each other? Okay, put your hands down. They can move.
Yeah.
Don't just get a sad now, right? He's like, oh my god, what happened? Look at the fan. Isn't the tip is moving with higher speed than the center of the fan? So there is a relative velocity or not? There is a relative velocity between the tip of the fan and the center of the fan. Yes or no? Now, they can move relative to each other, but is there a constraint in motion? How can B will have relative velocity compared to A? Relative velocity should be such that distance should remain same. So, what is the possible path of relative velocity of B? Circle. Right? So, if B has to move relative to A, it should move in a circle. So, it will move in a circle like this, keeping the distance fixed all the time. Are you getting it? Same way, all the points on the fan. So, please write down a rigid body, every point in a rigid body, every point move in a circle, every point move in a circle with respect to every other point. What does it mean? If you just see the relative velocity, all the points are moving in a circular motion only. It also means that the tip of the fan is moving in a circle with respect to center, and center is also moving in a circle with respect to tip. You are not able to see that because you are at rest and the center of the fan is also at rest. So you are only seeing what is happening with respect to center, because you are also at rest, center is also at rest. Are you getting it? But suppose you are moving with the velocity of the tip, then with respect to you, tip will be at rest. Are you getting it? And then you will feel that the center is moving in a circle. It is like when you are in a train, with respect to you, trees are moving backwards. Are you getting it? Similarly. Alright? So every point on a rigid body, if it has to move relatively, will only move in a circle relative to every other point on a rigid body. All of you understood this? Okay. Now, because of this property only, we are learning kinematics of rigid body. Kinematics of rigid body becomes relatively simpler. If it is not a rigid body, it becomes very difficult or complicated to analyze what is happening. Because it is a rigid body, I can treat as if it is a collection of circular motions. If I just look at the relative velocity. Okay, now all of you please draw a rigid body. You can draw some random shape and size of a rigid body. This is a rigid body, okay? You have this as a rigid body, and suppose this rigid body rotates. Okay, if this rigid body rotates, let's observe what are the points doing. I am taking point 1, point 2 and point 3. Okay. So, this line represents the axis of rotation. About this axis, this object is spinning. Fine, just like fan is spinning. Okay. So, that's how. Now, can you tell what is happening with the point number 1 when it rotates? It is moving in a circle. So this point number 1 moves in a circle like this. Okay. What is happening with point number 3? This is also describing a circle. Point number 2 also moves in a circle like this. Okay. So basically the axis is what? Locus of all these centers. Yes or no? All the circular motion center lie on the axis. Getting it? Now tell me one thing. If this point 1 completes one full circle in 2 seconds, how much time 0.3 will take to complete the full circle. 2 seconds only. If it takes lesser or more time, what will happen? Then the twisting will happen. Twisting happens of a rigid body, so it gets deformed. Fine. So all the points should move by same angle at same time. Are you getting it? Please write down all the points on the rigid body. All the points on the rigid body should rotate. Should rotate by same angle at same time. All of these are coming out because we are assuming it is a rigid body. If it is not a rigid body, all of these are not valid. Okay, so all the points rotate by same angle at the same time. All of you understood this? Okay, now tell me, the speed of point 1 is more or point 3 is more? What is more? Reason? It has to travel a bigger distance. Same amount of time. Getting it? Okay? So because of that, it becomes very difficult to analyze the motion of a rigid body in terms of distance, speed and acceleration. Because there are infinite points. All those infinite points will have infinite velocities, different velocities, different acceleration, different distance travelled. Are you getting it? So that is the reason why we don't use distance, velocity and acceleration when we are analyzing a rigid body. Okay? But the property of rigid body that they will all move same angle at the same time makes these angular variables handy when you analyze the rigid body. Rather than displacement, you track how much angle they have moved. It will be same for all particles. Right? Rather than velocity, you are tracking what is the rate at which angle is changing, which is angular velocity. And rather than acceleration, you are tracking rate at which angular velocity changes, which is angular acceleration. Alright? So, we are tracking angle, angular velocity and angular acceleration when we are dealing with rigid body. Alright? But finally, I should know that if I know what is the angular velocity, I must know what is the relation between angular velocity and the linear velocity or the actual velocity. Because ultimately, kinetic energy, when you write, it is half mv square. Okay? You know that what will be angular velocity. If you don't know the relation between angular velocity and the speed, it will all be useless. Because ultimately, all the formulas are in terms of velocity, acceleration and displacement. Right? So let us first see what is the relation between the angular variables. What are the angular variables? Angle, angular velocity and angular acceleration. And what is its relation between, what is the relation with the linear variable? Okay? Now tell me, if this point 1 has traveled an angle of delta theta, how much distance the point 1 has moved? Let's say this radius is R1. How much distance? Take a circle like this. If the point 1 has gone from this point to that point, this angle is delta theta. This distance is what? This is R1 delta theta. R length divided by radius is angle. So R length is radius into angle. Right? So, delta theta angle correspond to R1 delta theta distance. Getting it? What is the assumption here? The assumption is that the rigid body is staying at one place and rotating. If it starts moving and rotating, if it starts to move as well as rotate, then this is not entirely valid. Are you getting it? Okay, right now we are dealing with fixed axis. The axis is fixed. Or you can say that it is spinning. Okay. Fine. angular variable. And this is linear variable. This is what distance term delta s you can say. Okay, any doubts? Now, rate at which angle is changing is referred as angular velocity omega. We have done this in southward motion, yes or no? Something similar we have done already. So this is angular velocity. How do we find the linear velocity? Linear velocity is rate at which distance changes. Whatever. What? Why curtain close close jaldi? Okay. So this is angular velocity d theta by dt. Now, if you differentiate this, won't you get ds by dt? This is distance. If you differentiate distance, you'll get speed. Yes or no? Right? So differentiate it. R1 is constant, so R1 comes out. So it is d theta by dt. This is my velocity at any point in time, which is R1 into omega. We've done this earlier also. Okay? And there is something called angular acceleration. So d omega by dt is alpha. So this is my velocity. So if I differentiate velocity, I get acceleration. Dv by dt is r1 into d omega by dt, which is r1 alpha. So if I know omega at any point in time, I'll get velocity. If I know the distance from the axis, if I know angular acceleration, at any point in time, I'll get the linear acceleration of a point whose distance from the axis is r1. Are you getting it? Okay? Please write down in bracket this r1, r1, r2, r3 are the perpendicular distance from the axis. They are not any distances. You should find out the perpendicular distance. So, if I know the angular variable at any point in time, if I know theta, omega and alpha, I can easily know what is the distance traveled, what is the velocity and what is the acceleration. Yes or no? So rather than tracking these distance, velocity and angular acceleration, I will keep a track of angle, angular velocity and alpha because it is easier to keep track of these. There are finite points on the rigid body. I can't keep track of all of their velocity, all of their acceleration and distance. Are you getting the point? Okay? Okay?